Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
Welcome back to Spotlight. I'm your host, Jane Wynette. I'm joined now by Ann Sabota and Lauren Cassidy, representing the Ronald McDonald Family Room in Edward Hospital. So welcome.
Thanks for having us.
We're glad to talk about this topic. It's such a wonderful amenity in our community. So Ann, I'm going to start with you. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about the room at Edward Hospital, if you would.
Mm-hmm. So the room is actually located in the pediatric wing of the hospital, and it's been around for about 6 years. It's a great opportunity for people who have children or babies in the hospital to have a place where they can relax, get some food, and just take part in like a home-like setting. And it allows them to leave their sick children in the hospital, but be really close if they're needed. And it's just a great opportunity for them to relax a little bit, because parents do need that. They need to eat and they need to relax.
Absolutely. Well, I think it's always, they say, right, when mm-hmm. your child is sick, it's very important that you as a family are also taking care of yourself.
Absolutely.
So that you can support your child, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've seen it, and it's a wonderful, it is a very family-oriented room.
Yes.
It's very cozy looking. How are you able to offer those kinds of amenities to the parents and the families that come into Edward Hospital?
We are so lucky that we have lots and lots of volunteers and donors who give up their time and talent to help provide for the people who visit. We have, it costs about $85 to house a family in one of the sleep rooms. And because of all the donations we get and our fundraiser, we're able to only charge people $10 a night to
wow.
use it. And the other thing,
that's
too,
great.
Is if there is any chance, we never turn anyone away, even if they can't afford the $10. It's just a suggested donation. But all the food is donated, and it's a wonderful opportunity to have a place to relax and eat, and it's you know, free.
Okay. So now, how did you get involved with this? What's been your relationship? Because I know you've got a relationship with the room. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah. So, gosh, it's probably like 16 years ago, because my son's 15. We found out while I was pregnant that he had a congenital heart defect. And so we knew ahead of time, so we did all the research and stuff like that. And we just happened to be at the University of Chicago. That's where his heart surgeon was, his cardiologist. And one of the nurses that we were talking with said, hey, you know, he's going to be in the hospital for a long time. Have you thought about the Ronald McDonald House? And we had heard about the Ronald McDonald House before, didn't know too much about it. Well, when he got to the University of Chicago, when they airlifted him to the University of Chicago, we had that opportunity, and it was a wonderful, I mean, people donated food, people had, you know, massages. I mean, it mm-hmm. was a great place to also meet other parents who were in a similar situation to you are, because unless you've been there, it's really hard for other people to understand what
Absolutely.
It feels like having to leave your baby in the room. And it's a little bit different now, I think, but back then you were just in one big room.
Okay.
With a little chair that you can sit in, and they're not very comfortable.
Right.
Where they're spending lots of time. So I started with that, and he's doing great. He's had a couple other surgeries, but he's doing great. And when my kids got old enough, I decided that I wanted to not just give financially, I wanted to be a part of it. So I started volunteering and got on their community council, and I am in charge of the teen group.
Okay.
So
we're going to come back and talk a little
yeah.
bit more about that. I want to hear a little bit more. But Lauren, tell
sure.
us how you got involved with the room.
Sure. So my daughter was actually born 10 weeks early, premature. And so my husband and I were at the hospital every day for 72 days with our daughter. And while we were there, we were able to visit the Ronald McDonald room every day.
Okay.
We were there for lunch and for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
It gave us a chance to kind of just get out of our daughter's room and kind of decompress
mm-hmm.
and act like, you know, our lives were normal when they really weren't. So it was an opportunity for us to just kind of relax and to be able to not have to worry about going home and making a meal, and to also just kind of get out of that hospital environment that we were, you know, just very scared about, and be able to talk with volunteers and other family members, other that were experiencing similar things, to talk with other parents. It was just a very neat opportunity for us to just be able to step away and kind of just enjoy each other, and to be able to eat, which was important because sometimes you forget, you know, you're not thinking about what am I going to eat for breakfast or lunch or dinner. You're just worried about getting to the hospital and being there for your baby. So it was a really, really awesome place for us to go and decompress.
Okay. And so, I think, and you both touched on this, I think it's interesting. It's not just that decompression, but that connecting with other parents in that same situation.
Sure.
But not in such a hospital-like environment, right, which is more conducive to a little bit more natural conversation and
Absolutely.
Support.
Sure. I mean, I really liked being able to talk to another parent that was in a similar situation where there might be other outsiders kind of asking how are things going, and they wouldn't understand my particular situation, but there's another family that's sitting next to you that's experiencing something similar. It's you're connecting and creating a bond that really just can't be, you know, can't be copied.
Yeah.
So
now you talked, which I thought it's so interesting, because food, it is something that when you're stressed, right, you forget that to eat. So now, how do we get the food there? So tell us a little bit about the food, because that is an important part, right?
So I know that there are a lot of different donations that come through. There's a wish list that the Ronald McDonald Room puts together for the things that they need. So families or organizations, businesses donate often meals or just, I know the Girl Scouts, there were Girl Scout cookies galore. They donate cookies. My family actually, so I know that families that had children that were staying at the hospital come back and they donate kind of like on a birthday or something like that. So there's constantly donations coming in to help supply the, you know, 15 or 20 people per day that are going to be eating in the room.
Yeah,
so
that's a lot. I mean, that's a lot of people to be fed, right?
Sure.
And how what are other ways that the community can engage with you and support the work that you're doing in the room?
Well, we have a program called Meals from the Heart, like we were talking about, and it's run by volunteers, and lots of restaurants or even churches or book clubs or anything can, you know, volunteer to bring in a meal. It's usually around $250 for that, but then we have wish lists, which are great. We also could love volunteers, anybody who wants to come and volunteer. But we also have a fundraiser called Uncork Your Support, and I think it's on the calendar for next year for March 14th, and we have wine tasting, and there's silent auctions, and we raise enough money to provide over 1,000 nights of care for families.
Wow. That's
so
incredible.
It's our
That's amazing.
Big fundraiser, and through all of the donations that we get, we're able to save families over $10 million by providing them hotel-like stays and meals.
That's incredible.
So it's a wonderful thing to do, and you never know when that you're going to need it till you do need it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, listen, I am so glad that you came by, and I'm happy that both the children are doing well. That's a testament to the hospital, and what a great way to support the parents and the families that are going through that. So thank you for coming by.
Thanks for having us.
You're welcome. If you would like to find out more about how you can support the Ronald McDonald Family Room in Edward Hospital, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break. Stay tuned. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.